In this Q&A video, we're going to answer the question, how do I measure light levels in a room? This question relates to a video that I made recently on the Metrel A1172, which is a light meter attachment that plugs into your Metrel multifunction tester. It's a handy bit of kit, so do please go and watch that video after this one, especially if you want to watch me attempt some very poor cricket. Don't worry, I've already been given feedback by at least two members of the eFIXX team. But on with this subject. In the past, a lot of emphasis was placed on making sure that work and other spaces were sufficiently lit. However, with some changes to the building regs that took place recently, it's become just as important to make sure that spaces aren't over-illuminated as well. For more information on this, please check out the free accredited training package that we've made by clicking the link in the description. So you're in a situation where you've got to do some commissioning or maintenance. Maybe doubts have been raised about the final installation and if the lighting has been properly designed, and you need to carry out an investigation. You've armed yourself with a light meter to measure the illumination, but what you'll find is that when you move the meter around, the value will change significantly. This is because light is surprisingly variable depending on where it's measured. So where's the spot that tells us the correct light level in a space? Is it directly under a fitting, right in the corner of a room, or somewhere in between? Well, the answer is that you need to take multiple readings and then use those figures to generate the average illumination. How many readings and whereabouts? Well, I'm going to demonstrate on my workbench here, but this method works exactly the same for a whole room with one little proviso that we'll discuss in just a moment. The method I'm about to show you can be found in the SLL Lighting Handbook. The first thing to do is get the dimensions of the area to be measured. In this case, my workbench measures 0.78 meters by 1.46 meters. Starting with the longer length, we then need to use this rather scary looking formula, P equals 0.2 times 5 to the power of the log of D. All this is doing is helping us to find the value P, which in this case is the minimum distance between the points for measuring light levels, and is based on the longer length of the area to be measured, which is represented in the formula by that letter D. So in the calculator, it would look like this, 0.2 times 5, then press the power button, then log, and then the long length of my bench here, which is 1.46 meters. And just a pro tip, don't forget to close the bracket up here or it won't work. Then hitting equals gets us 0.26. This value is in meters and is simply the minimum spacing between points for measuring. Then we take that value and divide the length by it to find out how many points we'll be measuring at. So 1.46 divided by 0.26 gives us 5.62 points of measurement. Obviously, we can't do that in the real world, and so we will always round this number up, in this case, to a value of 6. So if we now divide that length of 1.46 meters by 6, we'll get 0.243 meters or 243 millimeters. Then we look at the width of the area and try to get back the same distance between measurements in that direction. So 780 millimeters divided by 243 gives you just over 3 measurement points. So if we divide the width by 3, we get 260 millimeters, which is only 17 mil off the other measurement and isn't higher than the minimum spacing we calculated at the outset. So now we know our spacings, we can set out the measuring points. On the longer side, the spacing is 243 mm, but when setting the first point, we come in half that distance from the edge. So that's 121.5 mm if you want to be super accurate. Then carry on at the 243 mm spacings, and that should give us 6 measuring points across the desk. And then repeat the process across the shorter dimension with that half measurement, then 260 mm spacings between points. Once we've got all of our points positioned, we can move on and start measuring up. So here we're interested in the illumination level on the desk surface. If we're figuring out the light level for a room, we need to think about the height we measure the light level at. There's a standard value used by many in the design world of 0.75 meters, which is about desk height, but you may need to adjust that depending on what the room is being used for. Also, if measuring light levels in a room, it's standard practice not to calculate the levels or take any measurement within 0.5 meters of a wall or obstruction like a pillar, as these areas are typically the darker parts of a room. Although, of course, if it's a room with desks pushed up all around the walls, then additional calculations or measurements of those desk areas would be a really good idea. Now we move on to taking the measurements. We'll use the A1172 from Metrel, and as this bench is flat, it's important to keep the meter flat and on the surface being measured. If we tilt it or lift it off the surface, we can end up changing the reading. So we go from point to point, measuring the light level and recording it. You'll find that even on such a small area as this, the values can vary pretty wildly. So then we take those values and find the average value of illuminance by adding them together and then dividing them by the number of values. In this instance, I've decided to use a spreadsheet to simplify the process. It's not always recommended to use a spreadsheet for complex maths, but in this case, it'll be okay. And there we go. The average light level on my workbench is about 520 lux, meaning it would be appropriate for using as an office that's used mainly for paper-based activities, at least from a lighting level point of view. Now, you may have noticed a bit of a difference between some of the readings that we took here, and that is often amplified for a larger space being measured. And so while the average illuminance is really important, there's another element to consider called the uniformity of the lighting. But we'll cover that in a future video. If you found this video helpful or interesting, you may like these videos just here. Thank you very much for watching.